All right, is everybody okay with each other?
No. Are you okay with my clothing?
Yes, I'm cool.
3, 2, 1. Aloha and welcome to another edition of It's Hawaii Thing. I'm Lanai and that's Brooke Lee.
Hi.
She's the one wearing the pink.
Yeah.
I love your clothes today.
Thanks, buddy.
Yeah. Boop. Do you like mine?
I can't.
Today we have a very special guest on the show. I've been trying to get him on for a while. We have some of his family members come on. But now we finally got him and I'm excited. He's been doing really well in the UFC. And he's just an overall, like one of those happy, just good vibe kind of guys. Mm-hmm. Yancy Medeiros, ladies and gentlemen. How are you, brother?
No complaints, man.
Good to see you, man.
Woke up on an island. Great to see you guys, too.
You have to follow his Instagram.
Yeah.
You wanna wake up and get it, be in a good mood.
Yeah.
Follow his Instagram.
Okay.
Yeah.
Give me more information.
Because Brooke doesn't follow anybody. She thinks she's Oprah.
He's obsessed. Yeah. First of all, it's Beyonce. Beyonce. It correct.
Okay. One of them.
They follow me.
Yeah. But yeah, he has a good energy and good vibe. Yeah. Vibe.
Okay.
Yeah. And he's a UFC fighter.
Yeah. So that's where I'm kind of getting the discrepancy because I'm like, you beat people up, but you're happy about it.
Well, that's not beat up. It's a sport. Yeah.
Well, I mean, it takes a lot to get in there, but it's always that mind frame. Like, I've never born and raised, but I've never had a street fight.
Ah, you know?
That's amazing to me, too.
It's a form of competition. You ever watch Ip Man?
Yes.
Yeah, you know how when Ip Man goes in and there's that dude, he's in the house and his kid's playing and he's like, oh, can drink some tea and see who's the best, martial artist. Whoever win, lose, oh, drink some tea, thank you, walk away. Like, I can look at it like that, you know?
Yeah.
Fortunately, I can get some money and pay my bills and take care of my responsibilities.
Right.
But it takes a lot to get in there.
It's a job.
Yeah, it's a job.
Okay, because I thought it was just literally angry people who get paid to, like,
no, those are beauty pageants.
Quid pro quo, get it. Okay, cool.
I think maybe they start off that way, but then learning to, you know,
a lot of respect
and you know their emotions. They know how to martial arts helps you navigate that.
Right.
So I think that's where they channel energy.
You have to manage it.
So when was your first fight? Like ever?
Oh, right. It doesn't when have I came to be my mom, man.
You were swinging.
No, I'm wrong. I mean, I'd say my first initial fight, like MMA wise, I was 19.
You're 19.
Wow.
Yeah, 19. Now, were you fighting in a competition or?
Yeah, it was a HFL. It was just some general MMA.
What did you feel like? How did that feel?
I mean, honestly,
because you never had a street fight.
Right, never had a street fight, but I've always had a form of competition.
Yeah. Mm.
So that's always, it's always that a sense sport. Of, it's always the same in that sense of if you're going to turn up, right? Like, I relate competition with me with everything, whether it's football, basketball, you all have that sense.
Yeah. Competitive.
We don't make it any different.
But the difference with our competition is we didn't get hit in the face. So I guess the question is when you first got hit in the face,
for yourself,
what did that feel like?
Oh, is there cussing around?
Version.
Ooh, you F on. You know, like it's fight or flight from there. So,
right.
You know, definitely get emotional. But a lot of my karate background, I did a lot of karate back in the day. So it helped me, you know, channel that. So.
I love watching this guy fight because it's such a, I mean, you're good at what you do, but the pre up to the fight, the weigh in and all the stuff they do for the UFC, he just has a different mindset than everybody else.
Well, when Ernie Reyes Jr. was on the show and he was talking about training those boys up.
Diaz, that's who he trains with, Diaz brothers.
Yeah, and so he was like, it's about a mindset. It really is the mindset before everything else. Because if your mind's not right, everything else is going to fall apart. So. Yeah,
we had Ernie on the show.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you train with Ernie.
Oh, he's a G.
I love him so much.
Yeah. I'll go with Nate into a couple of his camps. Unfortunately, I couldn't go up to this camp with him. But, you know, I always connect with Ernie and just.
Yeah,
he's the OG, so I'm always just trying to sponge whatever I can from him. Yeah,
he was just here, you know.
In Hawaii?
Yeah, he was in Maui. Maui.
Yes, I thought it was Oahu. I would have tried to connect with
during
him.
The pandemic.
Just like 3 weeks ago.
Oh wow!
Yeah. He was here, but he's always been trying to come back. But you know, he's been going through
his kidney dialysis.
Yeah, so it's not easy to just travel anywhere.
Yeah.
But you've been how many fights you've had now?
22, I'd say. I haven't give or take. Yeah.
And you haven't fought in a while.
Yeah, it's been like a year.
There's been a pandemic. You can't.
No, there have been fights.
Oh, they've been
during
fights.
The pandemic.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Every weekend.
How is that even possible?
No audience.
Oh, got it.
Streaming.
Are you gonna have an audience in the next one?
I don't think so. I don't think the UFC Apex holds a lot of people. Maybe. a few hundred, but nothing to where we can hold a crowd.
Is this the same thing? Isn't there a place in Bahrain or somewhere where they have an island where people go to
Fight Island?
Fight Island?
In Dubai.
Yes.
Yeah.
Is that for this?
No, they're UFC. Moving it back because the tiers have been released.
Is that for UFC or is that for?
Yeah. They had like a, I guess, negotiated something with Dubai, and they would have their fights there. But now it's back in the regular North America.
Oh, got it. Okay.
I think like Florida and Texas opened up. So, you know.
Because they don't care.
So
they went for it. Yeah. So that's what happened. How does the process work? Do you have to go, because you're waiting obviously to get the call. Yeah. Does your manager have to go and say, hey, we want to fight?
Well, we have like a negotiation, and that's where, you know, things, all fighters get injured or I get injured. Uh-huh. All of those things take into account. It's not like, oh, I don't like fighting.
Right.
Sometimes we're fighting, get things locked in, and then 2 weeks later he gets injured or something happens. Right. Or can we get another month? So it's all to negotiate.
What does your contract say? You have to do this many fights, X amount a year or anything?
There is a yearly thing, but they just re-up it, you know.
Okay. It's how good your management team is.
We're going to take a quick break. Hanging out with Yancy Medeiros. Don't go anywhere. It's a Hawaii thing.
Bringing you what matters. Viewers can receive the Star Advertiser digital full access subscription for just $9.95 per month. Go to staradvertiser.com and click on subscribe. Use the code AHITHING. HEC Medical Clinic, Dr. Aries Oda, Hawaii's number one laser weight loss center for weight loss, reverse diabetes, and heart disease. Call today for your limited time special, only $37. Lose 1 to 2 inches instantly.
Welcome back to It's a Hawaii Thing. We're hanging out with Yancy Medeiros talking about fighting UFC. And so you have a management team, and they go and they push you to fight. If they schedule you to fight and somebody gets hurt, they don't take you out of it. They find a replacement, right?
They try to find a replacement, okay. Or they find a date, you know, and then that's where management talks with matchmaking or Dana, and then they negotiate. Basically, they try and handle everything outside the cage.
So
just handle everything in the cage.
Do you think there's too many people now fighting because everybody, it always seems like everyone's waiting to fight now.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Well, I definitely think it comes down to, like, when I fight, I've been in it for about 8 years now in UFC as a client. So my pay rate is way more than these younger fighters. So it's like you can put in maybe 8 fights and still pay me. And one fight of me is like 4 other fighters saying, oh, I'm ready to fight and represent UFC. I'll fight for 8 Gs, whatever. Right. It's just the name. Get me in UFC. So obviously you see all these new fighters coming in and getting pushed out is what they want, right? UFC has a lot of cards and guys to fill in, and then if people want to fight me and they know it's a hard fight, and like the higher rank guy is like, I don't like fight Yance, he's not in that ranking, but it's still a hard fight. I'd rather fight someone higher ranking, but it's an easier fight. So all those things, like, I feel like I'm always a hard fight
for everyone.
So I think that's where negotiations
How many fights of the night have you won?
Ooh, maybe 3, 4, no, maybe
more than that, huh?
Well, what does that mean, fight of the night?
So that's when two people both get beat up really bad.
So it's like the Miss Universe pageant of fights.
No, it's like the most exciting fight of the night.
Oh, it's
and
the,
you win and, a big bonus. Oh, okay. But when you get that type of fight, you're putting on a show,
right?
Like these guys are going to the death.
Yeah, there's performance bonuses where you get like nice knockouts or finishes and whatnot, and then.
Wait a second. It's not just you get in there and it's like the sport. Like you got like bonus
incentives.
What's the incentives? Like break a knee?
No, knock them out.
Oh.
You know, you knock them out and it.
Some,
are we not allowed to talk about this? Am I going to get killed?
No. That's okay. For instance, like they're coming in, they're like, hey, bro, you put on a fight that's an extra 50 G's. You're like,
yeah.
Yeah.
So you can watch a fight and two guys will grapple the whole time, and it's not as exciting as two guys punching each other or boxing it out, just scrapping.
Knowing, but you premeditate that? Like when you walk in, you don't know what the other guy's going to do. So it's like a video game. You're like, oh, okay, you're going to go hard. Okay, we're going to go hard. And then, oh, there went my bonus because I just drew blood from his left.
You don't know, right?
His left eyebrow or whatever. Like, is that the bonuses?
Well,
is it Mario Kart? Are we like looking for things to ding, ding, ding?
Just
ding?
Do you. If you do you and you show that, like it'll
so
show.
So then there are reputations. People are boring fighters?
Yeah. Yes.
Most definitely.
And so Yancy is not.
Definitely.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. He gets fight of the night a lot. And the Hawaii boys especially like to scrap. They just like to bang. So that's why they're known. That's what these guys are known for.
Got it.
They put on a show.
Because you guys can beef.
They can beef.
Mama, mom. The moms, we got tolerate. The moms can drill us in good, huh? With the
king tolerance. How many fighters from Hawaii now?
Oh, over 10 now. Over 10.
Really?
Yeah. Yes. And then you have all the other leagues. I mean, you got one Pride, PFL. One
PFL. So, I mean, we have at least 20 to 50 Hawaii representatives. Wow. You know,
yeah, it's funny because every time somebody talks about a fight or Hawaii fighters or Hawaii fighters fighting, they always bring that up. Like, oh, this and here's another Hawaiian. These Hawaiians are warriors. You know, they just coming out. We have a lot. Yeah. Girls too.
Girls too.
Yes.
Yeah.
We have some scrappers.
Yes.
Oh, there's the Punahou girl, McFarlane. Am I making that up?
Ilima.
Ilima. Yeah.
She's awesome. Rachel Ostovich from Waianae. You have Kaylin Curran from Eva Beach. You have
and this is all in the UFC.
All different.
Oh, different.
Yeah. All professional fighters and promotions.
Got it. Is it a Olympic sport yet?
No, not yet.
Oh. I think it's gonna be soon.
I think jiu-jitsu will be there before.
Yeah, MMA, jiu-jitsu probably first. I mean,
should at least, but.
But it's so big. MMA is so big. It has to be.
Mm. Yes.
Yeah.
No, I mean, in the last 10 years, it's like, you know, I mean, it's on ESPN now.
Right. Who is the one that Ari Gold them own?
Who's that?
From WME. They bought.
Oh, UFC.
Oh, they bought UFC.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. I want to ask you about a couple of things. We've got to take a quick break. Don't go anywhere. We're hanging out with Yancy Medeiros, UFC fighter and all around good guy. Mr. Aloha, I like to call him. It's a Hawaii thing. We'll be right back.
This show is brought to you by Atlas Construction, Hawaii's number one builder for 8 years in a row. Call them at 808-951-9500 for the quality and service you deserve today.
Welcome back to It's a Hawaii Thing, hanging out with Yancy Medeiros.
So excited.
I wanted to talk to you about the Jake Paul thing. What do you think of that whole thing?
Why we got
to
talk about that?
Because Moi Lepo, like, calling out
he's
all
so
the
Eva.
Calling
the
out
Eva.
All these UFC fighters. I just want to get your vibe on that.
So gross.
Put me in the car and let me make some response.
No.
Let me do my responsibilities.
No, you are too good. He doesn't deserve to be in your presence.
We're in a world of obviously it's not quality, it's quantity.
Yeah.
Where we get Jake Paul headlining, co-meaning with Mike Tyson
that's
fight.
That's a horrible.
That's Twilight Zone.
That's so
that's
crazy.
Like, right? Like,
that's like next
so
level.
In that sense, like, why hate on it? Accept what it is.
You
what can I do?
You would fight that clown?
Huh?
You would fight that clown in a, really?
Yeah.
Would you do MMA or would you box?
Oh, I'd box him.
Why not?
I mean, it's just what the times is. These are the times.
Yeah.
It's what we gotta understand,
right? You just wanna lick him. You from Waianae. I know how it is.
It's just the fact that, like, when I look at now, look, the brothers fighting Mayweather.
Yeah, I know.
Right? I can't even process that.
Because Mayweather's a great boxer, but he's an even better businessman.
Right. Yeah.
And that's what he sees.
It's so crazy.
He's not going to go and choose a fight that Mayweather doesn't go into fights that he's going to lose.
But I'm, you okay, know, like, okay, I'll take your point. But, like, I'm more mad that there's a world where that guy gets to be in a room with all of you.
That's the mystery, and that's what it pisses everyone
deserved,
off.
He hasn't earned any rights other than being a YouTube whatever.
Well, so that's why, and if I ever had the opportunity, it'd be like,
you go to school
would be like Mortal Kombat, like Shang Tsung, like, just take it all. Like, take his soul, like, no, you don't belong in here.
Here's a map. This is why, and I, you about to get schooled.
Yeah, because he really picked the wrong guy. I mean, he picked the right guy. The wrong guy did it.
Right.
Because what was Askew didn't fight, he was like way overweight. He didn't even.
He wasn't ready.
Train.
He was smiling after that transaction.
Yeah.
What did he make?
Half a mil.
Oh,
you know what I mean? Like, for me, it's like my pride wouldn't, you know, my ego will step in front of that before.
Right,
you know,
I'm
more of a martial artist than I am. But when I go there, I understand that I am paid to entertain.
Mm. When
and
you
that's what they're doing.
When you first started fighting. You had, obviously, everyone, you started off with karate.
Yes.
What do you think you're better at now, today? Is it still karate? Are you better on the ground?
Definitely feel like jiu-jitsu is probably
jiu-jitsu?
Like my favorite.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Where I feel like, I'm not saying I'm better at it, but I definitely flow easier with
So do
it.
You think now, as you get older, you're going to go take, if you know that that's their weakness?
Oh, if I ain't punching your head off, I'm trying to rip it off. You know what I mean? It's either or. Like,
yeah.
So far, that's what's got me the bonus.
Well, go with what you know, Yancy.
But you know what I mean, right? Because some guys, like BJ is a good example. He's the king of jiu-jitsu, but he didn't use it to his advantage.
Right. And that's where, you know, my coaches and all them, like, Yance, come on, we gotta be the Yancey in the gym, not the Yancey under the lights. Because when the lights come on, I'm like, I want to be like Iron Man, like, boom, get back up, I'm like, all day, you know. But it's like way more tactical. I'm way more fluent. I have much more flow because I'm just more. There's the lights.
Do you think you're more patient?
Oh yeah, more tactical. My approach is just much more composed. The coolness, the clarity, and the calmness, and the connection of everything in the gym is always. It's like poetry, and then I go out there, and I'm just like throwing all my paint on the canvas, just throw it on, and hopefully I get a masterpiece.
He's just pollocking it.
My coaches is always like, yeah, "Come on, bro, we gotta show everybody."
The first time I watched my first fight, watching a MMA fight, I remember it was I can't remember who it was, but it was his first fight, whoever I was with, and the corner kept yelling at him. The first 30 seconds, breathe. Everyone was yelling, take a breath, breathe. And I was thinking, why are they telling him to breathe? It looks like he's breathing.
Yeah.
But he was so amped up, he wasn't literally breathing.
Right. That was the guy's first fight?
Yeah.
Oh, I tell everybody when they have their first fight, you're not going to hear nothing.
Yeah.
You ain't going to hear none on the corner, man. I'm letting you know. Like, I just let you know, you're not going to hear my voice. And sure enough, their first fight comes out, you heard my voice.
All the anxiety and everything takes over.
Takes a couple rodeos, takes a couple tries to get it down.
What is the worst injury you've gotten?
Probably during, I just dislocated my thumb.
During the fight?
Yeah.
And then do you guys just time out?
No, you
don't. Well, see, so what happened was is I never had an injury before like that. Like, I've never broke anything in my life. So that was my first UFC fight. And I'm like, I ended up defending a shot and then posting, and this thumb was just dislocated. And I was trying to like close my hand and it just was stuck.
Oh.
And I was just like, I was just like, oh damn, my thumb is like out there. And I was like, oh ref, what? We can like push this back in, because I didn't feel any pain. Like, there was no pain.
You actually said that?
Yeah, I was just like, oh ref, what? We can put this back in. And then he was just like, oh. And I literally thought it was going to be like Lethal Weapon.
Yeah.
You know, like, just push it back in and we're going right back. So unfortunately it wasn't, it's a safety issue, which I'm glad because I would have hit it. If I knew that, I would have hit it. Probably would have got worse.
Right.
So that was actually my first.
So that's where they created the Stockton slaps. You started slapping guys. Talking about fighting and UFC, it's definitely a Hawaii thing. This is such
MMA's
fighting.
Oh, fighting!
Just fighting.
Trying to represent who we are.
It's just the fine print on the Aloha Spirit. We all love, but then we not.
I get confused all the time when I try, because I travel so much. People always mistake me for BJ Penn, and then sometimes I go with it because I'm tired of saying whatever.
How does BJ feel about this?
Oh, he laughs at it because he gets mistaken for me, but only here. But I'll get mistaken and I'll go, but people always say, you Hawaii guy. I always hear it. Hawaii guys can fight everybody from all over the world too.
Right.
The people say that. Do you like that stigma?
Well, I mean, it's
not a stigma. Why is it a stigma?
To some people it could be.
Is it a stigma,
be.
Or is it our culture?
It's our culture. To me, it's our culture, but some people
I think too, it's not just necessarily fight with our hands, but we can use our voice pretty good too. Where there's mock, you're like, oh,
Who's the biggest talker you ever fought?
Talker.
Yeah, like who's constantly talking.
Who's the talking trash kind of like?
When fighting me?
Yeah, you
I'm
fought.
Fortunate, like they've never given me those vibes.
You know? Really?
Like,
really?
If they did, I would just be like.
Because you just are in the room and you shut it down.
He's
just
the nicest guy too. You fought Cowboy and you gave him a gift.
A Pontiac hat.
Aww, that's so cute.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, he's a cowboy. Oh, Hawaii has some.
Cowboy.
Yeah. Have some culture with Pontiacs. And then as a martial artist and as an entertainer, I respected him for that. Even though he fought my boy, like I'm still always my boy Team Diaz, Nate, all the time, but I'm not gonna take away from him and how good of a human he is.
Respect.
Yeah, I respect that. So I fought Yves Edwards, OG. He likes candy. I gave him chocolates, macadamia nuts.
Your mama raised you right.
No, she really did.
Yeah,
you
know,
meet his mom and his dad. They're awesome people.
Aww.
Yeah, I love hanging out with them in Makaha. I always like to ask people this because people always tell me, how come you don't get into jiu-jitsu? I don't like other people sweat on me. You ever roll around with somebody in the ring and you're like, this bugger smells bad.
I can't.
This guy stinks.
Not in the ring, but definitely at practice.
Practice.
Like you have them and you're just like, oh, this guy's got to be a quick one. You know what I mean? You got to come in here like, Let him know, like, and if you're my boy, I'm like, oh, bro, yeah, kicking like Bruce Lee and it's jiu-jitsu, so go fix it.
So I'm not the only one who thinks that.
No, like, well, for me too, it's like BO is a real thing for personally for me. It's just like,
well, because local people are not hauna. We're not like
no,
that.
No, I know.
Well,
even that sense too of just being attractive. If you get a bad smell, no matter how good you look,
that'll break and make or break for the girl.
Right.
So I mean, BO is just always a personal thing with me. So
okay. You never were in a ring when somebody was in one of your professional fights. Nobody had a bad odor in one of your fights.
Not that I know.
He probably shuts it off.
Me and Max would be training, and he'll just rip. A couple silent ones, and I'm like, giving the sneak shots, just those kind of things. Yeah. But other than that, like, we're too in the mold. Like, yeah, I don't let that stink smell is not gonna phase me while I'm fighting.
This is such the inside.
I'd rather smell that than
I always wanted to know.
Yeah,
I had no idea.
Yeah, it's a thing.
It's a thing.
Yeah,
no.
What do you like to do when you're not fighting? What's your hobby or your escape?
It's like knitting. I like kittens.
Oh man.
Besides drinking coffee.
Yeah.
This guy's a coffee.
Oh really?
Well, I love coffee, but I only drink it once or twice a day.
Oh,
so it's not like I'm like a fiend, I just enjoy it.
He's not that chronic
day.
With the coffee.
And it's real coffee. It's not sugar with coffee.
yeah.
So, but
watch his Instagram. You'll know what I mean.
But I mean, for the most part, I really do like spending time with family. After the COVID hit, I was always so selfish with my time, and I realized like one of my mentors always taught me like time is the biggest value you have. Meaning like, I can give you $20. Or you can give me $20 and then I can give you $20 back, but I can't give you 20 minutes of the time you gave me. Right? You know what I'm saying? That's your time. I can give you my time, but I can't take.
Yeah.
So I've been over
that's
those.
That's deep. Well, yeah, just that's, blew my mind well, just
I,
now. That's,
I think like that too.
Well,
I think it's the way we're brought
that
up.
Sense, and I think the whole pandemic really made you like put that perspective of time and truth and inevitability. So that the inevitability is truth and change.
Right.
Yeah.
It happens.
Yancy's blowing my mind again.
Wait, we got to wrap this up. You got a gift for him. Okay. Make sure you follow Yancy on Instagram and Facebook.
We got you gifts. So when you're training,
you can wear
the 88 T's shirt.
Yancy, good luck to you, man. Congratulations on everything. We're so proud of you.
Thank you,
Yancy Medeiros, ladies and gentlemen. It's a Hawaii thing. We'll see you next time. Welcome back to It's a Hawaii Thing, the extended version. Make sure you subscribe and hit the like button.
Yeah.
And also leave us a comment when you get a chance.
Don't
Yancy Medeiros is with us. Why do we say don't comment?
Because they're all haters and they're your fans and they'd say I'm too mean to you.
Yeah, leave a comment and tell her how mean you are.
At least they're giving you attention.
I'm not being mean. I'm checking a brother. That's what that
She's
is.
She's checking a brother.
Get with the program.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, Yancy, before when we were on the other break, you talked about time and spending time. You spend a lot of time in Makaha.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's family, and that's why.
Yeah. You in the water a lot?
I try to get in the water as much as I can. Unfortunately, I don't surf.
Yeah.
But I mean, you know, being around Uncle Brian, them, and the Kealana family all my life, like, I've always just been close to
the
water.
It's weird that he hasn't forced you to have to, like, he forced him to become a waterman.
Yeah.
Well, he didn't force me, but I was always surfing. I grew up surfing in the water, but then I almost drowned.
He literally
and he brought
trapped
me back
you.
To life.
He trapped you in the Molokai Hoi.
Well, you know, right? He's the only guy in the world that can make you feel comfortable in the water.
Yes.
Yeah.
I've been to Tahiti with Uncle, and like, could be 20 to 50 to 100 foot waves. If I'm with Uncle Brian and he tells me I can come, like, I'm like, yes, Uncle, let's go. Let's enjoy this.
Right?
Because that's like, I mean, he gets hired all over the world for water safety.
Yeah, yeah.
So if he's telling me I can come, of course. I feel secure.
Do you do any of the underwater training?
I just do it at my, by myself.
Yeah.
You know, I'll do some rock running here and there, but it's nothing to where it's a regime. I like to just do it to have fun.
Oh,
the beach is to decompress.
Yeah.
To decompress.
Do you have a problem with gassing out when you're fighting?
Oh, even if I did, I just keep going. You know what I mean? Like, I don't think it's the problem of gassing out. It's not how fast you get tired. It's how fast you recover.
Yeah.
Right? Everybody.
He's blowing my mind right now. Like,
you
he's
like his
my
phrases?
Guru. Yeah. Like, what's happening?
Well, and the reason I asked that because he trains with the Diaz brothers, and these guys are... They're non-human. They can run all day, swim all day, bike all day. I mean, their regimen is just incredible. Mm. Do you work out with them in that... status?
Yes. I mean, for the most part, I've experienced all those things that they put me through. I mean, Nick set me up with a triathlon, and I didn't even know I was going to do it.
Really?
Yeah. Like, I just, one day I came up to go train with him, and Nick's like, hey, man, you want to go and do a race, and I'm thinking like running, because we always run together. Right. And I'm like, I'll just go do a, you know, a 5K or 10K or whatever it was. Right. And then, so we're driving to Tahoe, and he's like, yeah, man, we got to do this triathlon. And I'm like,
wait, what now?
Triathlon? Like, I'm like, wait, what? Like,
what happened?
And in my head, I'm like, oh, ain't no bitch. And he's going to be like, oh, I can't do this, you know? Like, so I'm over there, and we get in Wednesday. The race is Friday. I've never done a triathlon. I've only mountain biked twice.
Wow. In
my, that was my, that was going to be my second
time. What was the triathlon?
It was an Xterra. It was a Tahoe Xterra.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
Wow.
You don't get, like, you got kidnapped and then thrown into an Xterra race?
How did you do?
It took me hella long.
Were you by yourself?
Yeah. This is the best part because Nick, when we got there, Nick forgot a part of his bike, so he couldn't even do the race.
What?
So I did the race. It's not like I would have been with him because he's just way, you know, a different level, but it's like, wow. Like, I went there by myself, and
That's hilarious.
Yeah, so he took me, but.
And then he had to punk out because he didn't have the proper stuff.
Right, he didn't have the proper
stuff.
But he
brought all the stuff for you?
Well, you know, I ended up renting a bike. So, but he got everything ready for me.
And then he was like, shucky darn, I don't have this part for my thing.
Right, but I don't think, like, that's the thing too. Like, he wouldn't go all the way from Stockton to Tahoe just to not race.
Right.
So, but anyway, I was doing it, and I remember, like, the biking was the hardest because it's elevation. Mm. And there's this old 60-year-old guy just ripping past me. Like, and I'm just like, what? Like, I'm like, bro, these guys. And he's like, man, this has been on my bucket list. And I'm like, off the bike walking, pushing it up this, you know, I'm like, because I can't breathe.
I get to the top
and I'm up there. I'm just like, dang. Like, I'm just like stopping there. And I get end up getting like blisters on the back of my heel. All these things. But I didn't stop. Like, I went. And I got down, and I remember going down and coming up to the run from my bike, because you swim, you bike,
bike and
you
run.
So I'm coming down to the bike, and I just see Nick sees me. He's like, like jumping up and down, up and down, because it took so long. Maybe he thought I quit, you know? Like, he's like, no, And then, so I finished the run, and then I finished the race, and he's like, bro, nobody does that shit.
Nobody.
Not one fighter is doing that right now. He's like, and it put me in a perspective. What I mean? Like, you push yourself through all of that. Like, how are you scared of a fight? Or how are you not going to be ready mentally, emotionally?
How long ago did you do it?
Oh, maybe 7-8 years
ago. Have you done another one?
No.
Because you did the Xterra. You don't have to do anything ever again. Yeah.
No, it's just the fact that I never put time into it.
Yeah.
You know, it's not I never have time.
You have to train
I never make
for it.
Time.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. People go do like the Ironman. I mean, they train their whole year. Yeah. He gets in a car and he's like, oh, by the way, we got to pick up milk, bread, and you're doing the Xterra.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I did Alex Pellin and I.
Yes.
This is about 10 years ago. We always wanted to do one of those triathlon things, but we did one of those Mountain Man one. So it was a 5K run.
Yeah.
And it was a swim. 5K run, and then the bike was like 13 miles, but it was in Kualoa Ranch, muddy and whatever.
Yeah.
And I thought, yeah, I can do them because I run.
Right.
So I can easily do that. I swim, I can do that. The bike part, I did not know. I had no idea what it involved with. So I finished last on this race, and there was about 500 people.
Wow.
They were packing up stuff.
Right.
When I was running, and everybody was cheering me on, and it was so hilarious because they had a loudspeaker thing, and they're like, ladies and gentlemen, he's last, but he's finishing. and I was so embarrassed.
Aww.
But I finished, but it was terrible. Everyone finished like 2.5 hours.
Oh, man.
And I took five.
I didn't do there was like the elite track or the elite route. I didn't do the elite one. I went like the middle one, right? And even the top guys beat me. You know what I mean? So I took a while too on mine, but I was like, yeah, I did it.
Yeah. You did it.
Yeah, I did it.
Do you get a necklace? Do you get anything?
They gave me some participation.
Yeah, I think they gave me something too, but I just all give it
to
my mom.
Blanked it out.
No, my mom, I have all my awards and all that. I give it to my mom. She cherishes them more than me.
What's your regimen like in camp? Like, what's your day like? You get up at what time and what do you do?
I'm usually in camp. I'm in about 5:30. I'd say I get up. I like to do my morning rituals. It takes me about 2 hours to just get up
and
go.
Let's drill down into this. What does this morning ritual look like? Like, is this like coffee and are you knitting? Like, what's happening?
morning rituals is like, you know, I go usually when like all my bathroom time is usually in the morning.
Right.
Like, right. It's a rhythm.
Excuse me.
It's that rhythm. Okay. So I make sure. All that's empty before I even leave my house. Drinking my water, my lemon water.
Right. Are you
watching
a show? Are you
my
listening?
Meditation.
Okay,
getting some sunlight. Whatever I can do with that. Like, I got some mind drills I do just to start the day.
Right,
you know,
right.
I don't think a lot of people take they just get up and then they leave. Just do what they gotta do, right? Yeah. But they don't do anything for
to
them.
To prepare.
Like, for them. Like, just
that's
for
great.
Them.
Right. You know? That's
like,
so good.
Oh, I'm
blowing
selfish.
My mind right now.
I'm hella you selfish. Have to be. You gotta be so you can be selfless, right?
Right?
Like,
yes.
You gotta
blowing my mind, this guy.
No, but I mean, like.
Like, Oprah, put him on your show, Sunday Souls with Yancy.
There you go.
Like, come on, Oprah. You are Maui. I see you.
She watches
you.
The show. That's
let's go, Oprah, please. I love chit chat.
So that's then you go through crazy. Your morning ritual.
Yeah, you know, and like, there's so much like chaos and stress, but it's like, I can't control any of that.
Right.
Like, with everything going on, vaccine, mask, all these things. Yeah. I've done it for a year. And they're like, yeah, you can get the vaccine. I'm like, I'm not against it. I just haven't had an opportunity, like a situation where they're like, you need to get this. Like, if it's going to stop me from traveling the world,
and
doing
fighting.
My job, like
yeah.
For the most part, I've been healthy. I'm a healthy individual. I'm not against it all. Like,
right.
I don't think it's mind control or any of these things. It's, I'm totally plant-based. Like, I love nature. I'm holistic approach, but I love science too.
And I
love logic.
Yeah,
you know, I'm very logical about things. So it's just what's going on in the world today. I can't control that.
Yeah.
How do I stay happy in this bubble, right?
Right.
So I just, my thing is always like, if there's something negative, like, how do I make that positive?
Yeah.
Or something bad's going on or in my day, I'm like, I ain't gonna give you the power to ruin my day.
Yeah.
I can't believe that MMA fighters are this woke.
Well, after you get hit in the face a lot, you realize that physicality is not really the answer for happiness.
You should start watching
so
what they
crazy.
Go through and stuff. I think one of the things I was in
I straight up thought you guys were all thugs.
No.
I'm a love thug.
One of the things that I'm impressed with fighters is their intellect.
Right.
Like, I've met so many fighters over the last years. Like, I mean, even like BJ, he gets this bad rap sometimes of doing these things or whatever. Mm. But if you ever sit down and talk with the guy,
right.
He's so logical and he has these insights on things you don't look at the way they do.
Right.
Because they're technical guys.
We
you know,
have
boxing
to be,
is so technical.
Otherwise, you die.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate because, you know, BJ, he gets a bad rap for things. But
he's
an awesome guy. He just
nicest
made bad
guy.
Choices.
Yeah.
Just like any human.
Right. Yeah. Right.
Right. We got to be there to understand and
it's a circumstance.
The end is like, who am I to judge? Like, I'm not religious, but I know there's only one judge, right?
Yeah.
If there is, who am I to judge?
Yeah.
I don't pay your guys' bills.
Yeah.
Right,
you know, I don't put food on your table or deal with the problems you guys have.
So
after you do your morning ritual, do you do cardio? What is it?
Yeah, whatever's on the I'd say I try and put 6 to 8 hours in of work.
Okay.
Like you guys, right?
Yeah.
Like throughout the day, going to practices, 2 to 3 practices a day and connecting.
Do you take a nap like in the middle?
If
or
I can, like I really listen to my body. Meaning like if my body telling me I gotta take a nap, like take that power nap.
So your coach doesn't do like, you know, like soccer, you do soccer drills. You guys have to do many different things. So do you change it up so it doesn't get boring, or do you keep a ritual for
I mean, there's certain things we I'll break it down. Like, if you was like a samurai going to war, right? Before you go war, where you stay at the blacksmith making sure he's building his sword, right? And then as war is getting closer, a month later, then he starts polishing and sharpening it. He's not in the blacksmith beating it down, right? It's as strong as possible now. See, now I have to make it sharp and shiny. So that's how camp is. So there's no in season and there's no in and out like off season. You training
that's
all
what
the
Chad,
time.
Chad Owen said the same thing.
Right, I mean,
you're always prepared.
You're always
Tom
training.
Brady is never on a break.
That's
why he has 7 rings. He's never stopped training football. That's why he has 7 rings.
Got
LeBron James, all these
but
top athletes never stop training. Yeah.
But for you, do you look at like, okay, I'm going to fight this guy. He's really good at grappling, so I'm going to work on that a little bit more.
Yes, there's a basis of what we have to watch out for attribute-wise.
Yeah.
I mean, everybody gets something that they can bring to the table, but how
so
do
you
I?
Guys are watching tapes and like you guys
oh, yeah.
know other
just
people's
like the football,
like things.
Just like football,
oh,
watching it, breaking it down. That's where your coaches come in. And some fighters do it for themselves. Some fighters do it with their coaches by themselves.
Right.
But all my coaches from wrestling to jiu-jitsu to striking, they all look at them, collaborate with each other, and then look at my attributes and my weaknesses. What's gonna make you win the fight and what's gonna make you lose?
And then how much do you you guys make a collective decision on who do you fight, or do you have people like on your like bucket list that you're just like, this is my dream list, these are the people I want to take?
I've actually never like had like guys I wanted to fight.
Oh, really?
I was always like, yep,
whoever.
Oh, yep. And just
whoever
tick the box,
the
tick the box, tick the box, tick
you know,
the box.
Like, I notice Hawaii guys are like that though.
Yeah,
Hawaii guys like whoever, give me whoever.
Double-edged sword, because it's more like you know, the right management, because some people will set you up because they want the right fights to win for a good record.
Right.
And for me, it's like, nah, you're not gonna pay $60 for see someone win one round, right? You like see him win the fight.
Yeah,
like, and
right.
There's a big difference when you see that. You guys see that too, like. They're totally content with winning a round, or I'm like, no, I like winning, period. Like, no, I don't like leave them to the judges. Yeah. Like, none of that. Like, all I know is when you let the ref and the judge
decide
your decision, right? So, block, put your hands up, don't look weak, and always finish strong.
Yeah,
and make you cry.
This is fascinating to me.
Like, it's just like if you have no, that's the, like, I always feel like if it goes to the end of the round. I mean, the end of three rounds or five rounds, like, it's a gamble, right? You don't know.
Yeah.
Just like Kai Kamoka, right?
Last night.
I seen the highlights, and I'm just like, I understand there's a gritty fight, but as a fighter and as someone I seen put out more, I thought Kai won.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It was like,
maybe it is a bias in me, but you know what I mean? But I just, I felt like he won.
Even the other guy thought that he won.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and the decision, his face was like, and then he kind of went,
wait,
oh, wow. Yeah, wow, oh, wow,
yeah,
I won.
Yeah.
Yeah. The other guy, they got fight of the night too, huh?
Oh, they should. Yeah, I mean, I never see what after, but those types of performances.
So what
should.
I'm hearing is that you're saying don't go to the third, knock them out before then so that they don't make a decision? Is that what I'm
Don't
saying?
Leave it to anyone
don't
else's.
Leave it to the judges.
Don't
leave it to the judges. I'm taking that to pageants. I'm going to tell the pageant girls, don't leave it to the judges.
That's what you did. That's why you won.
Well.
You were real.
It's a completely different conversation.
But that's his point, though, to everything.
It's like, but you won because you say it without saying it. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
that's all good. That's all good. Like, when I'm intrigued with someone and they're telling me, oh, I can do this for you. I can do that. Or I do this, I do that. It's not really, that doesn't really catch my intention, you know?
Yeah.
But when they just doing it and not talking about it, I'm like, oh, now you have my attention.
Blowing my mind right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's so awesome. You got such a good spirit and
that's
good,
so crazy.
Such good values. I think that's what made you.
I have such a newfound respect for the MMA world.
And you know what? When I said you were gonna come in, he's like, I don't know anything about fighting. I said, you don't need to know anything about fighting.
That's not true because I was obsessed with that show. Kingdom was my show.
I know, but when I said I was bringing in Yancey, you said something where
I don't know anything about fighting. I
don't
even know what to ask him because I don't know anything about UFC.
But you see how?
I'd rather you know me as Yancey than UFC.
Did you watch Kingdom?
Is that
on Netflix?
Is that the one with the Saxons and
Navy Street?
Oh no, this is MMA fighters.
That was.
Oh no, I didn't get.
Yeah, you should watch it.
Funny story though. So Nick Jonas was here filming Jumanji.
Yeah, he was on it.
Was he like, oh, he's obsessed with you, probably?
No. So
he is. Let's be clear, Priyanka.
So he's at this gym and Frank Trigg was
Frank
training with him.
He was
right?
A former UFC fighter.
Fighter, and Frank Trigg was like, hey man, he needs someone to hold some mitts for him and work, give him a workout.
Brian work on it too? On Jumanji?
I believe so.
Yeah,
but
Brian
was just doing the hitting mitts for the kingdom, right?
Right.
Just wanted to get
trainings
his looks in and whatnot.
So
I ended up doing a session with him and then I let him hit mitts for a while and then we're doing these things with gloves and we're going and I'm moving with him and I pop him in his face and he's like, like he looks at me like, you just hit my face. Like, you know what I mean? Nobody hits my face. I'm like, you good? Like, you know what I mean? I'm like, bro, I'm a pro. I know what I'm doing. Like, I'm gonna give you no black in my head. You know, I'm not gonna give you no black eye. But this is real.
Shit.
You know, but he literally hit me. He's like, oh. Like, he gave his, and then he just thought, I was like, okay, I'm not gonna do it again. But then I could feel him like giving a little extra. You know, I was like, oh, it was funny. It was a great interaction, though.
Did he have it? Could he hit mitts?
No.
Could he hit?
I mean, he's an actor, right?
That's why they turned him into the Mahu on the show.
No, then he died. Hey. Oh, did I give it away
he died
on the show? He died on the show.
He turned.
They made him the closet Mahu.
Let's be clear. You're born that way.
But in
Hawaii, he would turn now.
Yeah.
I got you.
On the show. he got me.
He discovered his inner feelings. Right. It was in the show. Yeah. And then he died.
While he was grappling.
Okay, whatever.
He made the connection.
You gotta watch it.
It's a good show. Frank Grillo is amazing in the show.
And
I do like Frank Grillo.
He's
a dang good actor.
From what I hear, be a whole different person. But they did well by the sport. They were very honorable about.
Now,
he's a boxer.
From working with Uncle Brian and whatnot, like I understand the whole stunt scene and how things look.
So you
cannot be like, oh, that's not how you fight. First off, you never even been in one fight, critic. And second off, it's a look. Like you know, it's like
that's why Joe Jonas goes like this. hits when you hit it. You're like, wait, nobody hits me.
And Yancy's been doing stunts too with on 5-0.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, yeah. We're getting the sad cards. Okay.
He's with Kehlana.
So yeah, well, it's in the blood. It's in the blood.
Yancy, thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, thank you.
I know you're busy. Good luck to you, brother.
Thank you.
We know we're always behind you.
Thank you.
You're always making Hawaii proud.
We're going to look for you on Oprah's Soul Sundays.
She knows Oprah. You got to set that up.
Her.
Make sure you follow Yancy on Instagram and all his social media. He's really fun to follow.
So funny.
And such a positive guy. And thank you guys for watching. Leave us a comment, like, and subscribe to the YouTube channel. Mahalo. It's a Hawaii thing.
Aloha. It's a Hawaii thing.